Well, everybody talks about egg quality, but there's no uniform way of measuring it yet. In fact, one of our embryologists, Emma Lazzaroni, is doing a study to see if we can actually measure the egg quality in an effective way. At the end of the day, egg quality is something we know it's there because we got good embryos. So a high quality egg gives us a high quality embryo, and there's a lot of agreement about what constitutes a high quality embryo. Blastomeres dividing on time, equal cell numbers, low levels of fragmentation, we've known that for years. What we don't know, and we can't in a standardized way predict, is which egg, when we pull it out, is necessarily going to become that high quality embryo. We're learning ways of trying to score that. And each of the embryologists at this point are looking at eggs in the sort of subjective way that you might go to the store and pick a good tomato or a good peach. A lot of different subjective issues. And in the study that Emma's doing, she's trying to quantify those things so we can learn even better how to do that. But it's all about egg quality, because the egg is the machine, really, that's in charge of early embryo development. You can think of the embryos as developing in sort of two stages. The first is sort of the liftoff stage. It's like the rocket just taking off from Cape Kennedy. The first few divisions through that whole liftoff, that initial development, are completely determined by how good the egg is to begin with. All of the RNA, all the metabolism that leads to those early divisions and makes it a successful embryo, are already present in the egg. The embryo, after it's gone through a series of those divisions, does something very magical, but it's farther down the line. It switches off from that program that's already in the egg, which is actually the mother's program, into the new program that's the embryo's program. And that happens down the line. So a embryo that's a good genetic conception, that is in a good egg, gets through that first stage and then gets to use its second stage, where it's using its own genes, its own program, and then you can have a successful pregnancy. But even a good genetic program that's in a poor quality egg will never get to that second stage. It never go through the sort of early divisions that it needs to get a high quality egg that has a chance of going on to the later stages. So the first step in embryo development is based on having a good, healthy egg. Well, over the last 10 years, there are two ways the doctor might be making those comments. He may be looking at predictive factors, like your hormone test, saying, oh, you have a high FSH, you're probably going to have poor quality eggs, or you're 42 years old, you're probably going to have poor quality eggs. Or he or she may be responding to what happened in an IVF cycle in which you produced eggs, but they became poor quality embryos. And he's saying, well, most likely this is because you have bad eggs. Egg quality is dependent on everything that comes before. So the eggs are sitting there, sort of on the shelf, all of a woman's life, and then they're conditioned and developed through those phases of development that go on for the weeks or few months before they actually enter the menstrual cycle. So a high-quality ovarian environment, a high-quality follicle, all those things will influence how the egg quality ultimately is. So the ovary is doing the final production on that egg, and everything you can do to improve the environment in which that's occurring has the potential of improving it. It's one of the differences of our approach here at CHR is a recognition of that opportunity, because many places will say that if you have poor egg quality, it's just because they've been on the shelf too long, there's nothing you can do about it. But now there's increasing, you know, number of schools of thought of different ways of trying to influence it. And people have tried using nutrition, people have tried using other kinds of hormonal treatments, we've been using androgens. It's likely that many of these different things may be effective. We haven't studied those nutritional factors or some other hormones yet. We eventually will. But the issue is that there's an opportunity to try to make it better, and we have evidence that we can do that to some extent. Somebody who either historically has poor quality eggs or have predictors that suggest they're going to have poor quality eggs, we believe we can improve that quality. We're never going to make them back into 20-year-olds. We're never going to make them back into the way they were 10 or 15 years earlier. We're just going to make them better. Ultimately, chances of pregnancy in a 42-year-old who's going through this process of trying to improve her quality will never be as good as that which you might get with a donor egg. But we can improve it so it's better than it was when she came in the door. Well, I think it helps the embryologist because there's probably also an opportunity in the laboratory. If you can identify an egg that needs more help, maybe you can handle it differently in the laboratory. Maybe you can approach it differently, use different tools, different culture media. At this point, we don't know that. If we can, the first step in developing ways of trying to treat them better or different techniques is to identify who needs the help.